As performers, we depend a lot on composers. Otherwise, we would be improvising everything, and although it might be interesting for a short time, certainly not for an entire concert. I approached one of my colleagues at Eastern Michigan University, Jeff Stanton, just between classes one day. We were talking, and I said, "Hey, what do you think about playing writing a piece for our trio?" And he says, "Oh, that sounds like it'd be fun." So he wrote this for us, and this is actually the first time that we, as Trio Abelia, have been able to perform it. So you're the first to hear us. And we're delighted that Jeff Stanton himself is here. And why don't you come up, Jeff? He'll tell you a few things about this that may interest you. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Denise. You know, it's very dangerous to ask a composer to speak about their own work. It's doubly dangerous to ask a professor to talk about music. So I promise I'll be short, 40 minutes or so. I'll go through a complete theoretical analysis for you. But this is my first time to hear them play this as well, so I'm just as excited as you are. As Denise said, we are colleagues at Eastern Michigan. David and I are enjoying a wonderful musical relationship. He's continuing to play an organ piece that I've wrote, which now I think he could call his own. And I'll tell you a little bit about the piece. It is two movements in one. So you'll hear an intonation at first, and then that gives way to a fantasy, which starts to pick up some steam, and there's lots and lots of dialogue back and forth between the players. And then that gives way to the second movement, which is inserted into the piece. And I guess I'll describe that as a boppy little tune. You'll hear jazz and rock and all kinds of things in there. So, and a little surprise ending.
Thank you. Thank you.